husband. But we thank God. Sobe, welcome back.
Thank you. Yeah, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Nneka Leonard. So I had a friend. She's late now. I lost her last month. So I heard that she's late because she had been of help to me for several occasions. So I heard that her burial would took place on Friday. So I couldn't meet up because of money. I don't have money. So I said, okay, even though I didn't meet up with her burial, let it be that I join her memorial service being Sunday. So I have to take a night bus on Saturday. So on Saturday, I left to Onitsha. I took a bus from Mazamaza. So dropped at Onitsha. Then they said it's late. It's better for me to go to Owerri. I will see a Port Harcourt because I'm heading to Port Harcourt. So I said, okay, getting to Onitsha, I bought a bus going to Port Harcourt. They said I won't take, it's better I go to Owerri. Then I will see those ones running, not at the park, the ones along the road, that it will be easy for me. So and cheap. So I took a bus to Owerri, as they said, 500. So I get to Owerri, control. I took a bus to Port Harcourt. So inside that vehicle I bought, the one going to Port Harcourt, we are five ladies that bought the bus. So, and three guys inside the bus. Mm-hmm. So the one we paid and the bus took off. So along the way, a guy, the one sitting behind me, brought out, I never knew what he was doing because the bus was moving. The journey was going smoothly. So all I noticed that a hand came, I saw a hand on my nose. I dozed off. So I don't know what happened. So woken up, I saw myself, my leg tied and my hand tied. I started shouting. So a guy came and said, are you mad? Why are you shouting? They don't shout here. Can't I see that the kind of place I am inside the forest? Why will I shout? Am I stupid? I said, somebody help, help. From shouting that help, he slapped me. Before you know it, six guys, they are the one that beat me to death. So after some minutes, I stopped crying because there's nothing I can do. When I saw them, empty men beating me, I struggled, I tried all I could, but I gave up. I said, maybe that's the end of my life. So they came out, the one is like their boss, that one came out and tore my clothes, naked me, totally naked. He said, it's like you are stupid. My bag, they started searching, they collect my phone, my ATM, every down thing. Mm-hmm. Ma'am?
No,
every
no,
down thing. So I started pleading with them. I said, please, I have children. You people should have mercy on me. What do you want? He said, the only thing that will save me is if I have people, I should start calling them. They said I should stand up. They helped me to stand. They snapped me, they covered my face, they snapped. They said, oh yeah, you can sit down. They pushed me on the floor. Then I started crying. I said, God, have mercy on my children. Who will I call? Where will I start? So yeah, I should open my phone because it's a fingerprint. I opened the phone. They said, oh yeah, show us all your relatives here. Are they in WhatsApp? I said, yes. They said, okay, start pointing at them. They want to send those pictures to them so that they will know that they are not playing. So they started posting the pictures. The other one said, ah, she not get that out. She not get that. I say, what are you wasting time for? Use her line to buy enough as data you can buy. If it's 5,000, if it's 4,000, that one is their problem. Buy and buy enough card on the phone. We are in business. So they started buying and buying. That's why they started posting my picture to my siblings. After that, they say, yes, that one is done. Oh yeah, I should show them.
Probably you
in
take
my
up the comments contact. Because people can't see your face properly. It's more better then. Mm.
Yeah. So that is when they started calling my people, one after the other. So they said, oh yeah, talk. I started talking to them. I'm dying, I don't know where I am, in a big forest. Say this, hey, do what happened? They say it's okay, give us the phone. They collect. They are the one that started talking to my relatives and all. I can't know how many they called because they collected all my. I don't have access to the phone again. So that is all the business I had with them. So after Sunday evening, Monday, they called. They say your people are trying to comply. So then they came and meet the one sitting by my left hand side. They said, ah, your people, you know, get people, nobody they call, or as this one, people they call about how it's like, now you be the next person where we go said. So that is when they pick up a phone, they dial the number. When they dial that number on loudspeaker, they said, ah, Alaji, fresh meat today, I'll go take one. Which part you need? Yeah. Alaji say, ah, breast. Breast. I need her second to the last finger. I need her eye. I need her ear. So he said, okay, then how much are you looking at? He said, Alaji, if you can give us 4 million, kill it. Nah, and send it. The Alaji started pricing. He said, let me give you people 3 million. It's okay. They said, done. They cut the phone. They carried the girl immediately. They had a very large, big table, but it's an iron table. So they took the girl. The girl started shouting, I don't have anybody. No mother, no father, I'm only child. They say, who only child help? Immediately they cut her head. They started physicing her. In my presence. So after some hours, they came back again. They took the second girl again. They cut her. They called and find out the part we need again. He explained that one, say her private parts. And breast and eye, that is the only thing you need. You want to use it that night. You have to carry the second girl again to kill in my presence. So we are remaining three. Then Monday morning, being around that kind 7:40 something, they took the third girl again and killed. That one they said is only her head they need. We are remaining two left. So they came back around that kind after 11. They say, ah, you are lucky. Hey, they call children. Yeah, we send you message. Your people don't pay. You are going by today. I say, God, I thank the second girl, the same thing. Say to Afuna, Mona, go if una go, come up for this place. Not gonna go do Thanksgiving. Say, na person will get person. Now you know, say, as they go. Shebi una see una people will follow una come here. And they don't feel lose them now. Nah. They don't feel lose money, lose them. Say they can't release them. If their people comply, I don't think they will be dead by now. But you people would have been like them. If no money, we are hustlers. We need money. So you people should go and thank God. So it's not up to 30 minutes. They called. They say, oh, yeah, come here. Your sister want to talk to you. They gave me the phone. They didn't give me the phone, no. They only put it in last because I start talking to her. That is when my sister asks, Anne, are you okay? I hope they didn't hurt you. I say, I'm in pain. So my body is paining me. I can't even see with my eye. By then, I can't talk because they shot my throat by holding me. So I can't speak out. I can't talk. But I tried to talk to my sister. She said, I say, auntie, if I stay here more than minutes, I will die. They don't give us food, nothing. She said, don't worry yourself. You are coming out by the grace of God. So getting to around 5:30, started raining. All the rain beats us inside that bush. So around that kind 7:38, they saw, yeah, stand up, point here, find your clothes, because I was naked. It's only one cloth they left for me, so I have to put it on. They make a call immediately, boy, show, 3 times. A bike came. They brought me out. They put me at the middle. One sat at my back. Getting to a main road, they pushed me away. Then they drove off. So around that kind 10:30. So I was roaming around, nowhere to go, and they said they is coughing. So that is when a guy passed. Many people passed, started running away from me because the way I look.
Is this 10:30 that night?
9:30 to 10 in the night. Mm-hmm. So then a guy came saying, I say, brother, help me. He said, where are you? What are you doing in this area? This place is very bad area. What I say, brother, help me. That they kidnapped me since 2 days, but they just dumped me now. I don't know where to go to. He said, okay, Oya, come. Can you go in my to my house? I say, brother, I will go. I believe that God sent you for a reason. He said, okay, that his name is Chibuzo. But he's living with his siblings. I said, brother, since 2 days, I've not taken my bath. Please help me. I know that you are the only one that stand to talk to me. Other people passed me. He said, okay, that is how we bought a keke to his to a junction. They get into that junction, there is coffee. So no vehicle, no everybody was trying to get home. No way. So it's not quite like 10 minutes after. A coastal bus came up. People started rushing to the bus. So the brother carried me. He helped me enter that coastal. Get into a place. He paid. We came down. He took me to the house. Explained to the siblings that I saw this lady. Oh, this is what she told me. So they welcomed me. They gave me water. I bathed. They feed me. They gave me the one of the junior ones went out to get me pain relief. They said, okay, are you with any sim? I said, I pleaded for them. I said, please, the one that sat at my back, can you please, brother? I know I don't supposed to tell, but I have to speak. Help me, please. I need my SIM card. Even though it's only one SIM card, please. He said, okay, just because you say I always had you say children, children. If not that you say children, children. I have a pity for children. Oh, yeah. Let me go and help you to get this. So he's the one that gave me the SIM. They collected other things. My Jew, everything. So is that SIM card I put in their phone, that brother phone. I use it to start calling my people that they have released me. So that is how my sister said that she don't worry the next day. Being yesterday that she will send money to the person that I'm with, maybe to his account to help me. For me to locate her. So that is how I got out. So yes.